So I've just added a couple of bits to the game here. So I've just added the just tidied up the output for the scores that each person got. And rather than saying player one, I've added their names. Okay. The plus, incidentally, just adds it onto the string without a space. So in this case, so if they put Bob, I've put sort of apostrophe S, so Bob's. Which is why I've used the plus there, just to tidy up the output. And then down here we've got the thing that declares who the winner is. So if dark count player one is greater than dark count player two is the winner because player two is throwing the least darts. And then what I can do is just tidy it up a bit up here. So I could put a couple of just blank print statements in because at the moment, as you can see, it all goes in one sort of big chunk of text. So it's probably worth just tidying it up a little bit. So let's stick a couple in here. So it won't look great, but it will look okay. So let's have a look and let's see how it looks now. So it should declare a winner this time. So it's first to from 200 to zero. So Jim and Bob. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, close. One other 5 seconder. 4 seconds. A bit lazy, I can't be bothered to wait for these. Okay, so that's his go over. So 1 second. So Jim threw 3 darts, we can see there. And Bob, here we go, is not that great, mainly because of my laziness. Okay, here we go. So he threw 7 darts. So Bob 7 to Jim's 3. Jim is the winner. So we could personalize this further by saying Jim threw 3 darts. Now it's Bob's turn. Think about how you could do that. It's not as straightforward as you might imagine, but it is certainly possible. So that's how to build a kind of reaction-based darts game in Python.